தேசிய அளவிலான ஒருங்கிணைப்பாளர்கள் ஒருவரான திரு வி பி நந்தகுமார் அவர்களை இங்கே தமது கருத்தை பதிவு செய்யுமாறு அழைக்கின்றேன்.
Good morning, everybody. It's nice to see this big gathering here. I was having a look outside and the weather was very fine actually. It would have been good that if we had all met at Elliott's Beach as usual in the last 3 years. Weather is quite good. But anyway, the conditions are that we are here to talk about science, and science has found a way, has a way, so that we can sit here and meet and see that the tradition of March for Science continues. So that is one thing. I see lots of people who were there for the last three marches, and I'm also very happy to see that there are a lot of new faces in this march here today. We are here at a very the India March for Science, as the speakers before me have told, what was the motivation for forming the March for Science, first at a global level, and then from 2017, how we have taken it up throughout India. Many science organizations have come together, many scientists have come together, and many people, lay people who love science, they have come together to give strength and number to this March for Science, and that is why it has continued from year to year to year. And seeing the participation here, the strength of participation is no less. It's very, very encouraging that people feel so much for science that they are willing to spend some time on a Sunday morning coming here to talk about science, to voice their concerns about what is happening in science. Professor Ramanujam very ably presented what are the challenges facing science, what are the challenges facing society, and what is the inheritance that those of us who have been around for a long time, who have this respect for science, who understand what science is all about, that science is not just physics, chemistry, mathematics, but it is that also, but that science is a way to look at life. It's a road to the future, as he placed. And that it's very important that the new generation gets a correct picture of science, because many times the technical aspects of science takes precedence and the concept of science takes a backseat. That what is science for? It is there to understand life. It is there to understand society. It is there to understand each other. And with the proper understanding of science, it is not just a way to go to the moon or go to space, but it is to strengthen human society, strengthen human relationship. That is what science is for. But this, for the past few years, we have seen a tendency, not only in India, but all over the world. The forces of anti-science, and more dangerously, because it's most hidden, the forces of pseudosciences have raised their heads. And because many of these people are in power, their voices are being heard, and it is unfortunate that the media, which once projected itself as an independent fourth estate, which will comment without bias, without prejudice, many of the media who should be giving picture to the people of what really science is, they have sought for interests of their own to side with the powers that be. I'm not, one feature I see that in India, even in the Indian Science Congress, ideas started being propagated about ancient Indian science. Ideas such that the actual worth, the actual achievements of ancient Indian science became diluted by the type of things they were presenting in these forums. I mean, I need not repeat them, that we had cloning back in the Vedic age. We knew plastic surgery in the Vedic age. We could fly flying machines in the Vedic age. All these things were there. And when you say these things in front of the international community, then all you succeed is in making what actual achievements were there in astronomy, in medicine, in mathematics, in many fields of science, where in ancient India we contributed to the world, you make that insignificant. People get diverted by the type of, you know, you have a joker in a king's court. It is antics by these type of jokers that are happening. Now this you can laugh at. Now, the problem is, in the past few years, they started telling things that were not there. They started making a big thing about myths, and so that the real achievements were hidden. At the same time, in the past few years, the India March for Science has been really presenting problems before science. Funding, encouragement to basic research, the ideas of secularism, that feelings of communalism, the feelings of caste, all these things should not take place. Secularism means in public life, what matters is that religion does not play a role. It is other things that play a role. And we have been worried about the funding for science, what is being taught in the classes. And we have been talking about the need that if you want to oppose this, you need to develop scientific temper, scientific thinking, how to think properly, project the lives of great scientists, the struggle they did. And this has been represented to the government year after year after year after year. Now, what has happened is, now in this corona period, we see through the back door, why should I say back door? They have taken that people are arrested at home, that people are helpless, and in every field, they have been bringing in policies which are, only one simple word for it, anti-people. It does not work for the sakes of the people. It serves some other people, people with other interests, people with big corporates, big multinationals. It is their agenda that is being foisted on a people arrested at home. Now, what is, before they used to talk about our science was like this, but already some speakers have pointed out that what is happening, I particularly say in the field of education, because education is the mode by which science reaches students. In the field of education, such attacks are coming. The syllabus has been cut in the excuse that we do not want to burden the students. Instead of enlightening students, giving them a vision of the future, giving them a vision of life, you will say that whatever they have opposed in the past few years, like theories of evolution and many things like that, they are actually had the audacity to remove them from the syllabus. That is one thing. And the new education policy that is just passed, actually there were many people from 1986 itself, there was opposition, but one new education policy after another kept coming. Last time it came 2016, 2019, opposition was there. Instead of taking those things into account, instead of consulting with the people, because they say we are a democracy, but they don't consult with the people, they don't consult with the parliament. And if you look deeply into the new education policy, this attack, I say, for present and future generations, this attack is more calamitous than the coronavirus today. Even though the coronavirus is there, we know what to do about it, what are the steps we have to take to prevent it. But this education, the attack on education, the gutting of the scientific essence in the syllabus, this is something we should all be aware of. We have to take it to the children that they are being presented with an education system that is not going to do them any good. In fact, instead of taking them forward, it is going to take them backward. So that is something all of us should be aware of, all of us should be concerned about, and which we should take to our children, we should take to our friends, that it is not a policy, it is not 66 pages, but underlying them, one of the biggest attacks on...
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
So we should be really worried. I do not want to carry on further, but we should be really worried about the situation. But hope is there. Science gives us hope. Science gives us hope. The way that we have gathered to get today, that gives us hope. So we should take science as a method of looking at problems, as a method of how to solve problems, at how to work together. And from this, we should proceed. Proceed. It does not end today. August 9th is one day. It's good that the day has come. We have to take things forward from here very seriously, especially our younger ones. It's very good to know that many young people are here. They are so keen to know what is being said. It is not to be, you know, the young guy who was asking, I don't understand Tamil. What we should appreciate is that child's interest to know. Now, as long as this is there, the interest to know, the interest to learn, and we can cultivate that, then there is hope for the future, and our March for Science will go forward. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Nandri, Nandakumar avargale.